Namaste, in this video I am going to make elliptical gear in solidworks. So to make elliptical gear, I first select the front plane and click on sketch. Now select the ellipse. Make sure that these two points are in vertical. To do that, press Ctrl, select the origin and select this point. After that, click on make horizontal. Now as you can see, the sketch becomes completely black and it is shown that it is fully defined. Click OK. After that, click on extrude base boss, select mid plane. Enter the value of 20 mm. If you have ever watched my previous videos, you watch most of the time that I always use mid plane in most of my geometries or simulations. The reason is that when you select the mid plane, it is quite easy to use mate, mirror or many other commands. So I always prefer to do extrusion by using mid plane, not others. Now again select the front face of the ellipse, click on sketch, press Ctrl plus 8, select center line, draw the center line and extend, press escape, select the edge, click convert entities just to make the sketch at the outer edge. After that, click on line. Now draw a line randomly, click on smart dimension, give it height 6 mm, press escape. I make a mistake because of that. Make sure this line is above the center line. After that, enter the value of 5. The length of this line is 11 mm, this line is 3 mm, press F. Now go to offset entities, select the edge of the ellipse, enter the time value of 15 mm. Click OK. Again, select the offset, go downwards, select for construction, click OK. Select this point and this point, make it coincident. As you can see, it is not coincident because we set a value of 15 mm here. So click on it, just delete it. As you can see, now it's completely made. After that, go to mirror entities, select the entities you want to mirror. I'm going to mirror about center line, click OK, click on extrude, select this teeth. As you can see, it is opposite direction, so click on reverse direction, click OK. Now do a fillet. The radius of the fillet is 4 mm. Click OK. Select the front face, press Ctrl plus 8. Go to linear pattern, select curve driven pattern. Here it is asking for the pattern direction. Just click on this plus icon, click on the boss extrude, select sketch. Okay, as you can see, I am in the center line of this part. Now select fillet and boss extrude in the features to pattern, Make sure you select offset curve and tangent to curve. Click OK. As you can see, now we have made our spiral gear. Now Control plus, now press select sketch, Control plus 8. Enter the value of 30 mm, extrude cut, OK. Again click on sketch, now extrude cut it. Let's say 5 mm. Now mirror it. Okay, we have done some mistake. Okay, I've selected the wrong plane, so select the front plane, click OK. Now it's done. Click on fillet. Click OK. Select face. Control S. Name it ellipse. Press Control plus N. New part. Center distance is 162. Extrude it again, press Control plus 8. Enter the value of 30 mm. Select this edge, press Control, make it concentric. Draw a center line, select this circle, click on mirror entities, click mirror about, select this line, click OK, extrude it, say 50 mm, Control save, base, press Control plus N. Click assembly. First thing I need to do is right click on base, make sure it is float. Now I am going to mate base first. Select the top plane, click on mate, select the assembly top plane. Now select the right plane. Select the right plane of the assembly also, click OK. Now select this face and this face, click OK, press F, select this face and this face, click OK, exit, press Control, select this part and and as you can see, I remove this part. Now do the mating with this part too. Click OK. Right click on base. Sorry. As you can see, our base is currently still moving. So top plane, right plane. Let's see, in which direction is moving. It is moving in upward direction. So what I'm going to fix is top plane. Press Ctrl, select top plane, click mate. Click OK. Now it is not gonna move. As you can see, okay, it is still moving. I don't understand the reason. So right click on it, click on fix, because I just want that part remain fixed, nothing else. Press F, Ctrl plus 8. Just little upwards, make sure just touches the surface. Now go to motion study, select contact, select these two gears, click OK, click calculate. The reason is does nothing because I don't use any motor, anything else. It's night here and my mind is not completely working. Sorry for that. So select, press control, right click on it, select other. Okay, I'm not able to select. Make sure you select edge ellipse and it moves with respect to the base. Select the base, click OK, press F, press Ctrl plus 8, minimize it, press calculate. Okay, as you can see, it's working. Now go to motion study properties, increase the number of frame rate, let's say 67. Click on calculate. Select playback mid loop. Click play. As you can see, it's rotating, but at a very high speed. Let's reduce the speed. First, we need to do stop. Right click on rotary motion. Click edit feature, let's say 20 rpm, click OK, click calculate. As you can see, it's rotating. I hope you like this video. If you have any doubts and queries, you can comment on it. Thanks for watching and have a great day.